quy chuẩn. Ông chung việc các mặt to cái tham gia can thì tham gia ca hay tham gia ca là mặt to từ ní ông việc tôi tham gia ca sẽ đáp sắc khi cam này dùng niên hong ri lô ca một trời bao là cái chương này dùng niên chung một căn cái này bắt đầu khi cam không tụt tham gia ca bạn xuống đây lục nẹt chùm nến ta lục chùm mùa ấy
Henri Locar
bà lục bật tiếng chùm chùm mùa Henri Locar
ô con lục Henri Locar ta lục cả nơi ngày khai chín năm ná lục chạm đại tỷ
yes I do record on the 11th of June
1939
French
ខ្ញុំ សញ្ជាតិ បារាំង
អរគុណ ហើយ លោក Henri Locar តើ លោក ចេះ ភាសា ច្បាស់ លាស់ ឬ ស្ទាត់ ជំនាញ ហ្នឹង ប្រមាណ ភាសា ដែរ
French and English and a little bit of Khmer
ចេះ បារាំង អង់គ្លេស ហើយ ចេះ ខ្មែរ តិច តួច
បាទ អរគុណ ហើយ អញ្ចឹង ដោយ សារ លោក ចេះ ភាសា 2 ច្បាស់ លាស់ ហើយ អញ្ចឹង ទេ នៅ ក្នុង ឡុង ពេល នៃ ការ ផ្ដល់ សក្តិ កម្ម នៅ ចំពោះ មុខ អង្គ ជម្រះ ទឡា ដបូង នេះ ពេល នេះ ថា លោក នឹង ប្រើ ភាសា អ្វី ដែរ
Well, I shall answer in English to questions in English, and I shall answer in French to questions in French. In questions in Khmer, I shall answer in French too.
ពីភាសាក្នុងពេលសកម្មភាពនោះអង្គជំរះសូមរំលឹកដល់លោកថាបើសិនជាលោកឆ្លើយតបនឹងទំនួលរបស់អង្គជំរះឬក៏ពាក្យគីនីនីសូមលោកកុំជៀសវាងក្នុងការផ្លាស់ប្ដូរភាសាព្រៀមៗនៅក្នុងឡុងពេលឆ្លើយតបគឺដើម្បីឲ្យដំណើរការនៃសកម្មភាពយើងប្រព្រឹត្តទៅបានល្អលោកសប្ដាហ៍នេះតើលោកមានទីកន្លែងលំនៅឋានអចិន្ត្រៃយ៍នៅទីកន្លែងណាដែរ
For the time being in Phnom Penh.
បដាហាសាននឹងខ្ញុំស្នាក់នៅទីក្រុងភ្នំពេញ
ចុះទីលំនៅអចិន្ត្រៃយ៍របស់លោកលោកនៅទីកន្លែងណានៅប្រទេសណា
Well, I also come from the town of Lyon in France. But on my passport, my permanent address is given here in Phnom Penh. I'm a resident in Phnom Penh.
អរគុណហើយលោកប្រកបមុខរបរអ្វីដែរសប្តាហ៍នេះ
I am retired from the University Lumière Lyon 2 in France and I'm also a volunteer at the Royal University of Phnom Penh History Department This since the year 2000
គឺខ្ញុំចាប់ផ្ដើមធ្វើការនៅសាកលវិទ្យាល័យភូមិន្ទភ្នំពេញតាំងពីឆ្នាំ2000មក
បាទអរគុណអ្នកជំនាញហើយតើលោកមានជំនឿឬក៏គោរពប្រតិបត្តិសាសនាអ្វីដែរ
Roman Catholicism
ខ្ញុំកាន់សាសនាកាតូលិក
បាទអរគុណហើយតាមរបាយការណ៍របស់គឡាំជីសំណការកាលពីព្រឹកមិញនេះថាតាមសមត្ថភាពដែលលោកអាចដឹងគឺលោកមិនមានជាប់ចំណងញាតិលោហិតឬក៏ញាតិពន្ធជាមួយនឹងជនជាប់ចោតទាំងពីររូបលោកនួនជានិងលោកខឿនសំផនទេហើយក៏ដូចជាដើមម្ដងរដ្ឋប្រវេណីដែលត្រូវទទួលស្គាល់ក្នុងក្នុងរឿងក្តីនេះទេតើពិតតែដែរឬទេ
Yes it is correct
បាទលោកប្រធានគឺត្រឹមត្រូវហើយ
បាទអរគុណហើយលោកហងរីលូកាដោយអនុវត្តតាមបទបញ្ញត្តិនៃវិធាន312នៃវិធានទៅក្នុងនៃអង្គជំរះវិសាមញ្ញក្នុងតុលាការកម្ពុជាក្នុងឋានៈលោកជាអ្នកជំនាញដែលត្រូវផ្ដល់ថៃកម្មនៅចំពោះមុខអង្គជំរះអង្គជំរះតម្រូវឲ្យលោកធ្វើសម្បត្តិឬក៏ធ្វើសច្ចាប្រណិធានជាមុនសិនតាមជំនឿសាសនារបស់លោកមុននឹងផ្ដល់ថៃកម្មតើលោកយល់ព្រមដែរទេ
Yes, I do.
បាទលោកប្រធានខ្ញុំយល់ព្រម
កញ្ញាលោកក្លាមជីសមរការលោកស្រីម៉ាឡាម៉ាដាលេណាសូមណែនាំនីតិវិធីសម្បត្តិដល់អ្នកជំនាញនៅចំពោះមុខអង្គជំនុំជម្រះសូមអញ្ជើញ
Thank you Mr. President.
សូមអរគុណលោកប្រធានលោកកាតសូមអញ្ជើញក្រោកឈរ
Please repeat after me. I solemnly swear that I will assist the trial chamber honestly, confidentially, and to the best of my ability.
Solemnly swear that I will assist the trial chamber honestly, confidentially, and to the best of my ability.
Thank you. You can sit down.
Thank you.អ្នកជំនាញអង្គជំរះនិងភាគីនានាសូមថ្លែងអំណរគុណចំពោះលោកដែលបានមកផ្ដល់តក្កកម្មនៅទីនេះហើយរំពឹងថានឹងជួយដល់អង្គជំរះនៅក្នុងដំណើរការស្វែងរកការពិតពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងបញ្ហានានាដែលកើតមានឡើងដែលមានសារៈសំខាន់នៃសកម្មភាពនេះនិងសម្រាប់ប្រជាជនកម្ពុជាទាំងមូលហើយមុននឹងសួរអំពីប្រវត្តិសិក្សារបស់លោកនឹងអស្ការស្រាវជ្រាវនឹងស្នាដៃនិពន្ធមួយចំនួនរបស់លោកអង្គជំរះសូមរំលឹកអ្នកជំនាញថាពាក្យបាលីពុយសាសគឺជាពាក្យបច្ចេកទេសតាមផ្លូវច្បាប់ដែលមានការកំណត់និយមន័យជាក់លាក់តែដែលអង្គជំរះមានតែអង្គជំរះតែមួយគត់ដែលសម្រាប់ថាតើផុសតាងនៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងនេះបានបង្ហាញថាមានអធិភាពនៃអង្គភាពបាលីពុយសាសឬអកតកម្មផ្សេងផ្សេងទៀតដែរឬយ៉ាងណាហើយសូមលោកយល់ថានៅក្នុងកិច្ចដំណើរការនីតិវិធីនេះមានតែអង្គជំរះទេដែលសម្រេចក្រោយពីបានពិចារណាពិនិត្យផុសតាងអង្គហេតុនិងអង្គច្បាប់និងសក្តិសន្និដ្ឋានរបស់ភាគីនានាហើយក៏វាមិនមែនជាបញ្ហាដែលលោកអ្នកជំនាញឬក៏សាស្ត្រីផ្សេងទៀតត្រូវផ្ដល់សក្តិសន្និដ្ឋានឬក៏មតិយោបល់ពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងអង្គើបល័យពិសាសឬក៏អកតកម្មនានាត្រូវបានបង្ហាញនោះដែរហើយលោកក៏មិនមានតួនាទី ក្នុង នាម លោក ជា អ្នក ជំនាញ ក្នុង ការ ផ្ដល់ តថ័យ ក ឬ ក៏ មតិ យោបល់ ទៅ លើ ការ បក ស្រាយ ពាក្យ បលាយ ពិសាស ឬ ក៏ បញ្ហា ផ្លូវ ច្បាប់ ផ្សេង ផ្សេង ទៀត ដែរ តើ លោក អ្នក ជំនាញ យល់ ទេ
Yes, I do.
Except that
I believe that there is one minority in this country which has been forgotten by the tribunal. As far as I can see, I have not read everything. And those are the Khmer, what the Khmer call the Khlungs. There are some from Southeast Asia, Indo-Europeans, and I have some evidence, and Dutch gave some evidence that Indians, Pakistani, were collected at the beginning of the regime and all exterminated simply because of their ethnic origin. And that's all I have to say on the subject.
បាទអរគុណហើយបញ្ហាសំខាន់ពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងអង្គហេតុដែលអង្គជំនះកំណត់ធ្វើសម្លាការនៅតាមម្ដីការតំណោះស្រាយដែលចាប់កាន់ចំពោះជនជាប់ចោតហើយបញ្ហាខ្លះទៀតគឺជាការព័ត៌មានបន្ថែមដែលលោកបានជួបប្រទះហើយវាអាស្រ័យទៅលើសំណួរភាគីឬអង្គជំនះពាក់ព័ន្ធទៅនឹងបញ្ហាដែលពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងចំណេះដឹងរបស់លោកឥឡូវនេះយើងសួរបញ្ជាក់បន្ថែមមួយចំនួនពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងប្រវត្តិសិក្សានៅក្នុងដៃនិពន្ធរបស់លោកអ្នកជ rum kamrat na dae
I think this was in my
biography.
I was mainly educated in Lyon, secondary and higher education. I finished also in the Sorbonne in Paris. After that, I also spent 3 years in England. In the course of my academic experience, I started my academic career as a teacher in the French school here in 65-67. I first came to this country in 1964 as a student on the invitation of somebody working for the British Council. In 1965-67, I was asked by his minister, the Minister Chau Seng, to write some article for the magazine Cambodia. I was sent to Ratanakiri and investigate the Laban Siak rubber plantation, now in Bandung. So that was my first experience in writing or in publishing anything I owe to Chau Seng. Chau Seng, who, as everybody knows now in this court, was interrogated and exterminated at S21. When I came back to France, I got immediately enlisted in the University of Lyon, which later became University Lumière. I was working in the English department, the University Lumière Lyon 2, and also teaching in the Political Science Institute. I had a sabbatical in 1993-94. To redirect my research on democratic Cambodia. In 1989, I returned to Cambodia on the invitation of a friend whom I thought had died, but I'd survived, and I was so horrified by what I saw in Cambodia, what Cambodia had become, that I tried to understand what had happened and why so many people died. I started researching democratic Cambodia from about 1990. That's for about 25 years. I took a PhD in the year 2000 on the ideology of the Khmer Rouge and the system in the countryside. I had it also in Singapore, in Australia, as invited for fellowship or further training. That's about. And I retired from the University of Phnom Penh from the University of Lyon, sorry, in the year 2000.
សូមឲ្យលោកនិយាយឲ្យឆ្ងាយពីក្បាលមីក្រូបន្តិចដើម្បីកុំឲ្យវាខ្ទោខ្ទោអ្នកស្ដាប់ពិបាកស្ដាប់ហើយបាក់បកប្រែភាសាបាទឥឡូវយើងសួរបន្តទៀតឲ្យស្ដាប់មិញយើងលោកបានបញ្ជាក់ហើយថានៅក្នុងឆ្នាំ2000លោកបានសរសេរនិក្ខេបបទឋានៈបណ្ឌិតផ្នែកប្រវត្តិសាស្ត្រស្ដីពីទេសនាវិស័យសម្រាប់អង្គការនិងមនោគមវិជ្ជាក្រមរបបកម្ពុជាប្រជាធិបតេយ្យសំណួរសួរថាហេតុអ្វីបានជាលោកជ្រើសរើសយកប្រធានបទនេះធ្វើ
Why? Simply because I wanted to understand, for personal reasons to a large extent, why some of the friends, dear friends I had known in the Songkum days had disappeared.
Why this has
been this catastrophic regime, 1975-79, and
why Cambodia was brought back, it seemed,
one or two generations from the Cambodia I had known in the
60s.
And to some extent, through collecting the slogans, that is the ideology of the Khmer Rouge, by looking at how was it that so many people died, and investigating the prison system. Why the prison system? Did I start with this prison system? Because after this first day in some 1989 in Cambodia with my wife, I was speaking in the local radio in Lyon on the Khmer program, and somebody rang me and said, wanted to meet me, and this was Meng Son and his wife. And Meng Son was by then a refugee in France. He'd worked in the oil refinery in Kompong Som. And he had been a prisoner under the Khmer Rouge for about 18 months, 6 months at the beginning of the regime in Tanay prison, 1 year at the end of the regime in Kok Chong prison in Prinup district. And he wanted to write his story. He tried with several people and failed. So I started to record him. It took more than a year because Meng Son was very busy. And I was amazed to by his experiences in the prisons, and I couldn't believe that a human being could be treated in such a way by his own compatriots. So this is why from 1991, I started in the summer because I was working full-time at the University of Lyon. I spent all my summers, 91, 92, 93, and so on, until I retired, investigating the prison network and see if there were similar institutions, similar to Prinup district. And everywhere I went, every district I went, every province I went, I asked Min Kuk, or were there any prisons, and each time I had the answer, mean, there is. In other words, there was not a single region, province, district, where there was no major prison in democratic Cambodia.
So
we first published with a very good editor the memoirs of Meng Son and his wife Pali. And then during that investigation, people would give me slogans. I wrote them for fun. I didn't think they were so outrageous and such a caricature of thinking and of philosophy that I wrote them on little notebooks. And in the end, I had so many that I could publish them into books. And I have a French edition, 1994, I think, and an English edition at the beginning of the year 2000. On top of that, I wrote a number of articles. Therefore, I was able, in the year 2000, to collect all these published works and have what we call in French une soutenance sur travaux, published works, and then I collected all the articles. I had an introduction to my studies of more than 100 pages, and that constituted my PhD.
Thank you very much, Professor Mithiwi.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Juste
une précision, j'ai l'impression que Monsieur Lokar lit des notes. Je voulais juste
précise que
I'm very honored that the defense lawyer says that I seem to be reading notes. I can tell you, I have no notes except the sentence I was supposed to read.
Thank you very much.
All right, well, the first book is
the biography of Meng Son and his wife, Pali.
And it was published by Faya,
and
under the title Prisoner of Anka. I could not use prisoner des Khmer, en français, prisonnier de l'Anka. Prisoner of Anka. I could not use the title Prisoner of the Khmer Rouge because it had been used by Sihanouk in one of his memoirs. But the Khmer version the English version is Prisoner of the Khmer Rouge. That was the first one. The second one was my book or slogan, which is called Pol Pot's Little Red Book. French edition and then English edition. I'm not quite so sure that I would call it today Pol Pot's Little Red Book, because I've been convinced now that the country was led not just by a single man, but by an Anka or a Soviet, a group of men. And this tribunal has shown that brother number two, Bong TP, or Uncle, as Dutch call them, number two, is from the point of view of ideology probably as important as Pol Pot.
So I would
rather call it, you know, the two brothers,
Little Red Book,
or the Red Book, Little Red Book of Angkor.
Lately,
I published in French.
Now, suppose you pisa barang.
Yes. Why the Khmer Rouge? Yes. Which is a summary of all my findings on the,
a
book that was commissioned by one editor. I did not ask. They commissioned me to publish it, to write it, and publish it.
And,
there is now just coming out this month a second edition of this book,
in a paperback edition,
of which in which I made many corrections. Many corrections, if you take into account what has been said in this court, because I do believe that this court is throwing new light on democratic
culture
regime.
Suing
Sikun, I made, after working with a victim, mainly
Meng Son,
I worked with a Khmer Rouge intellectual, as this court knows. Originally, a publisher asked me to do a biography of a Khmer Rouge intellectual who had been trained in France.
A composite portrait,
but I didn't think it was a good idea. I preferred to have a real human being. So, first of all, I thought of working with Chun Mum. And we had an editor. Unfortunately, Chun Mum had a health problem and couldn't work. And he said, why don't you try Suing Sikun? Suing Sikun is the husband testified in this court. He is the husband of my compatriot, Law Speak.
Now,
this has been a very long work. And Suing Sikun has been a difficult person to work with. Now, this court must be aware of that. But in the end, we produced what some people have said was a very useful book called Itinerary of a Khmer Rouge Intellectual, published by a good editor. And in that book, I wrote a foreword, but I wrote about 50 pages of the, what I call the actors of the drama, that is, biographical notes of all the Khmer
Rouge
leaders who are mentioned
in
this book. Then there's a number of articles. But these are the main books. I have chapters in books also. But these are the main things. I've also worked with Pipun.
The Jarai,
who testified at length at this tribunal, and with Sohong or Salot Ban, who also wanted to write their autobiographies, with Pipun, who died, as everybody knows, just a year ago. We have finished the work. I have a publisher. I saw it in the text. Will lead to a publication of the book or just a long article. One of my models has been Philip Short.
Philip Short has written excellent books,
history of a nightmare, because he interviewed many Khmer Rouge leaders, intellectuals, including at length,
Khmer Kyaw Sampon,
and I think the source, a very important source to understand the regime, is of course the Khmer Rouge themselves, when they are willing to speak, and it's easier to speak privately with private individuals than within the formal surrounding of a court.
ដូច្នេះហើយគឺអ្វីដែលសិនបើគាត់អាចថ្លែងបានវាជាការល្អបាទអរគុណហើយលោកបានធ្វើការបង្ហាញយ៉ាងក្បោះក្បាយនៅស្នាដៃនិពន្ធរបស់លោកហើយនឹងគូបំណងនៃការនិពន្ធបន្តទៅទៀតនៅបញ្ហាមួយចំនួនដែលលោកមានការកត់សម្គាល់និងចាប់អារម្មណ៍ហើយសំណួរបន្តនេះតើលោកធ្លាប់បានធ្វើការសិក្សាស្រាវជ្រាវអំពីអំពើបល័យពិសាសដែរឬទេ
I'm not sure I answered the question. You mean research on genocide? I did not make any specific research on genocide.
I'm
not a specialist of genocide like Ben
Kenan.
I'm just a simple historian, and I've done some research on crimes against humanity in general, not specifically on genocide, except you're talking about countries. I'm not a specialist of the Nazis, ideology, for which the Nazi has been coined. So, apart from the Klung I mentioned earlier, I have not made any specific research on genocide.
បាទហើយជាបន្តទៅនេះយើងមានសំណួរមួយចំនួននៅពាក់ព័ន្ធពីសភៅដែលជាស្នាដៃនិពន្ធរបស់លោកហើយត្បូងនេះយើងចង់សួរពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងសភៅដែលមានចំណងជើងថាពួរគាត់លើខ្មែររូសតើលោកចាប់ផ្ដើមសរសេរសភៅនេះនៅពេលណាហើយផ្សព្វផ្សាយជាលើកដំបូងនៅក្នុងឆ្នាំណាដែរហើយរហូតមកដល់ពេលនេះតើលោកបោះពុម្ពប៉ុន្មានលើកហើយ
Yes, I think the editor Vendémiaire in Paris asked me around the year 2010 to do this book. Friend Stéphane Courtois. Stéphane Courtois is a Frenchman who is the author of the Black Book of Communism, which was published at the end of the 1990s and which covered all communist regimes throughout the world. Made quite a scandal when it was published because he said that the total number of victims of communist regimes was around 100 million. So through Stéphane Courtois, the editor Vendémiaire asked me to do a book, a general book, on Democratic Cambodia for the French public. The book came out, was finished in 2012, was published in 2013, sold quite well. So this is why in 2015 they asked me, they wanted to make a paperback edition. But as, of course, making a general book about Democratic Cambodia is very uphill work, very difficult, there are so many sources. I was not quite satisfied with what I had written in 2012, so I made many improvements, I hope, and through new knowledge that I had acquired to a large extent through talking with Pipun. Pipun has been a very useful source. And this book has been sent about 10, 12 days ago to this court, the new edition. I don't know if it has arrived. I think that in the English language, by far the best book, general book on democratic Cambodia is Pol Pot, The History of the Nightmare by Philip Chu. I don't have his talents of writer. My book is more pedagogical, more for students and journalists in general who want to have a summary of all the aspects of the regime, how it grew, how it developed, and how it collapsed.
ទីមួយគឺសភៅដែលលោកបានជួលមកហើយបានកែសម្រួលចុងក្រោយនឹងបោះពុំនៅឆ្នាំនេះគឺអង្គជំរះបានទទួលរួចហើយហើយដាក់បញ្ចូលទៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងរួចហើយហើយអង្គជំរះក៏ចង់សួរផងដែរថាតើលោកអាចរៀបរាប់ដោយសង្ខេបដល់អង្គជំរះបានស្ដាប់ដែរទេថាតើការបោះពុំផ្សាយទាំងពីរលើកនេះគឺនៅក្នុងឆ្នាំ2013និងឆ្នាំ2016ហ្នឹងវាមានចំណុចខុសប្លែកគ្នាយ៉ាងម៉េចដែរ
Well, you're asking a very difficult question. I'm not sure I can really answer clearly. I try to avoid, I eliminated some paragraphs, some friends told me that were too controversial. I tried to put in new information that I got mainly through readings, and through the courts, and through my interviews, mainly Khmer Rouge apparatchik. Going into details now, I don't think I can.
I hope that I've made it more readable.
I'm not very happy with this edition because I disagree with my publisher about the cover. I wanted a book cover to have both Pol Pot and Nguyen Chia, and they claimed that they could not put the two on the cover, and apparently I have not yet seen it. There's only Nguyen Chia, which is absurd, and Pol Pot has disappeared, which is completely absurd.
I don't think the index is well done. And I hope to make an English edition which would be much more academic and better. I always hope to improve myself because one can always do better.
បាទអរគុណហើយតើលោកអាចបញ្ជាក់បានដែរទេថាសិភើនេះទៅសេសំនៅប្រធានបទសំខាន់សំខាន់អ្វីខ្លះដែរតាមដែលលោកក្នុងនាមជាអ្នកជំនាញហើយជាអ្នករៀបចំនៅសិភើនេះពីរដងហើយលោករយរាប់សង្ខេបឬបានហើយព្រោះសំណួរយើងក៏សំណួរបឋមដើម្បីភ្ជាប់ដំណើរការនៃនីតិវិធីពីដំបូងទៅនឹងសំណួរដែលពាក់ព័ន្ធដែលអង្គ ភាគីពាក់ព័ន្ធផ្សេងទៀតនឹងសួរលោកស៊ីជំរឿឬបញ្ហាផ្សេងៗនៃពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងបញ្ហាភាពជំនាញរបស់លោកដែលអង្គជំរះបានសម្រេចតែងតាំងលោកធ្វើជាអ្នកជំនាញមកប្រតិកម្មនៃចំពោះមុខអង្គជំរះនេះតើសិភើនេះសរសេរពីបញ្ហាអ្វីដែលជាចម្បងឬក៏សំខាន់លោកអាចរៀបរាប់ដែលសង្ខេបបានដែរទេ
Well, of course, my main subject area would be the
provincial prisons.
I recommended that
this court has concentrated too much on S21. Of course, that's easier because we have such a mass of archives, and we are so lucky to have the director of S21, the only of the five accused who spoke and collaborated with the tribunal and enabled to have much of the truth come out. I'm not saying that he was not lying by omission. Some of the things that he said were not necessarily always true, but to a large extent, years helped us considerably. It is a pity that the tribunal, from my point of view, has concentrated too much on internal purges the singled out victims like Vietnamese, Cham, and not sufficiently concentrated on just ordinary Khmers. In the provincial prisons, the vast majority of the victims were just simple Khmer people from all classes, not just the favored classes, the favored classes at the beginning of the regime, but from 1977, all classes were taken to these dens of horror, even the most innocent victims, and in total, they probably include about one-third of the people massacred or who died as a democratic Kampuchea. I have not obtained, coming from an English department, from the French authorities, I have not obtained research funding for that research. So it is done on my own expenses. Translators, interpreters. I tried to work with DCCAM. When DCCAM was launched, I had already covered quite a significant proportion of the country. DCCAM wanted to investigate the pits, but I said the pits have been already investigated by the PRK period, so it's very easy to investigate. To research what has already been researched. Much more interesting would be what has been discovered by David Hawke, an American expert, who said, well, there's not just S21, there's not just tool slang, but there are tool slangs all over the country. This he discovered, and this is what I investigated. And then, well, basically, DCCAM rejected my offer of services, first because I was a Frenchman, and DCCAM director is not very fond of French people, apparently, and there's no French, he was American educated. And to, I came with my pockets empty. I came with no money. My experience of interviewing people and of the country didn't seem to weigh very much. So I continued alone, and then came along the tribunal. So I thought, this is the job of the tribunal. So I dropped my research. I don't know exactly what percentage of the field I covered, half, two-thirds, but a significant proportion of the land. In 2010, a PhD student called Luc Benesch wanted to do a PhD on the prisons in Cambodia from the colonial period. Because, as everybody knows, it is the French who established in every province the legal system, and that I know people, official prisons in Cambodia before the French protectorate, just places where people were temporarily detained sometimes in Khmer. Shackles, iron shackles. But Luc Benesch has abandoned his research and has limited his PhD to the colonial period.
I've seen some notes about the provincial prisons which I did not make for the tribunal.
As I, to my somewhat disappointment, I thought the tribunal has not done enough field research, principle murder of extermination. If you study the Nazi regime, you concentrate on Auschwitz, but what about the other concentration camps? All over Europe, this is a bit like how I feel here. But what about all the other prisons?
ហើយក្នុងនោះក៏មានទីដាក់ក្នុងដៃក្នុងជើងទីផងដែរ ទាំងឡាយដែលកើតមានឲ្យសពគ្រប់នោះបានទេពីព្រោះតុលាការនេះមានអនុញ្ញាតការងារហើយបញ្ហាសំខាន់អង្គជំរះបានទទួលនៅសំណុំរឿងដែលដែលការបញ្ជូនរឿងជំរះចោតប្រកាន់នៅក្នុងប្រតិភិសារភាពនៃអង្គហេតុដែលចោតប្រកាន់ជាផ្លូវការមកចំពោះខ្លួនបំណោះមិនអាចពិភាក្សាដេញដោលឬក៏ធ្វើអ្វីលើសពីសមត្ថភាពនិងលទ្ធភាពដែលមានហើយនឹងធនធានដែលមានហើយនឹង ច្បាប់ដែលបានកំណត់នៅក្នុងវិសាលភាពនៃដែនកំណត់នៅក្នុងដីការដំណោះស្រាយដែលចាប់ប្រកាន់ពាក់ព័ន្ធទៅនឹងជនជាប់ចោតនោះទេណាហើយលោកអាចប្រាប់យើងបានដែរអង្គជំនះបានដែរទេថាតើលោកប្រើប្រាស់នៅវិធីអ្វីខ្លះនៅក្នុងការស្រាវជ្រាវដើម្បីទៅសេសិភើនេះហើយតើលោកប្រាប់ថាអាចប្រាប់ដែរទេថាប្រភពឯកសារឬក៏មូលដ្ឋានអ្វីខ្លះដែលលោកពឹងផ្អែកដើម្បីទៅសេសិភើនេះឡើង
Are you talking about my last book, Pourquoi les Khmer
Rouges?
Well, like every historian, I have secondary sources and primary sources. Secondary sources, I tried to read, of course, all the main authors, and first of all, David Chandler,
his book
about Cambodia, history, a general book of history, or the tragedy of Cambodian history, which covers more recent period. His book on S21, his biography of Pol Pot. Next, of course, as I mentioned earlier, is the very important book by Philip Short. Philip Short's biography of Pol Pot is, I'm afraid, better than that of the academic, because Philip Short did more field work, and interviewed from Khmer Rouge officials, intellectuals, apparatchik, however you call them. And therefore, he's a very good writer, and therefore, his book is absolutely a mine
of information.
I was also
believe a very important primary sources
the
life stories, autobiographies of the victims of the Khmer Rouge.
There are
about 30, 40, 50 altogether.
I've got so many
at home.
I've read
all those that were written in French.
I've read, I believe,
mostly all those that were written in English.
And
I think they were a very important source. I must say, I have not worked on the Song of Peng Wei archives, on the Tuol Sleng archives,
because,
first of all,
barrier
of language, of course,
I would have had to use translators.
But the second thing is that, as all researchers were concentrating on S21, I did not need to duplicate the work of so many distinguished colleagues.
So my sources were,
to a large extent, mainly
oral,
from my interviews.
I don't know how many Cambodians have interviewed,
perhaps not as many as Ben
Kianan,
perhaps not as many as Michael Vickery, but certainly hundreds and hundreds, if not thousands. These are my main sources.
And of course, articles,
sometimes they were excellent
articles.
And speeches. And the Foreign Broadcast Information Service has been a very important source. It has been a very important source for this tribunal.
And
it's marvelous we have speeches by
Kim Somphan, by Kim Phat.
We have the description of all the visitors.
We have the propaganda.
Unfortunately,
we don't have
nobody in the world, neither the BBC nor the Americans, copied or registered all the programs of Democratic Cambodia
radio, which is a pity,
because we don't have the songs, we don't have the slogans,
We
certainly miss many things. But that's a very important source.
ឥឡូវនេះដល់ពេលសម្រាប់ថ្ងៃត្រង់ហើយអង្គការប្រកាសសម្រាប់ចាប់ពីនេះទៅទៅរហូតដល់ម៉ោង1កន្លះរសៀលនេះសូមអញ្ជើញចូលវិញដើម្បីបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្រាប់ការហើយមន្ត្រីរដ្ឋបាលការរួមរស់ផ្ដល់កន្លែងសម្រាប់នៅបន្ទប់រងចាំសម្រាប់ប្រសាសីដល់អ្នកជំនាញរូបនេះនៅក្នុងឡុងពេលគឺសម្រាប់និងអញ្ជើញគាត់មកកាន់កន្លែងផ្ដល់សក្ការកម្មក្នុងបន្ទប់ធម្មការនេះវិញនៅវេលាម៉ោង1កន្លះរសៀលនេះហើយប្រកបឲ
Sông chênh khóc chô.